On today's show, we pump up the volume with KFC's Transistor. What's going on, peoples? This be your boy Smith with another Transformers super awesome review, and today we will be taking a look at KFC's Transistor, which is their take on a Masterpiece Blaster. Before we get into the figure, let's take a quick look at his packaging, shall we? Here we have here, looking all kinds of BA Transistor. I do like this nice piece of artwork. Got a G1 head sculpt looking there. He is part of the Heavy Metal series, Phase 4A, I think it is. It's a little silhouette. Yeah, Phase 4A. And on the backs, kind of a little product shot of what he comes with. And here again in his boombox mode. Also, real quick, it shows you with the G1 head. In the packaging, it actually came with the traditional G1 blaster head, which is weird because it's, you know, not. Anyway, and of course, this is something I always like when you can open up and see the figure inside. And it's got a nice little shot of him in robot and boombox mode. It's not held together with magnets, unfortunately, just Velcro, but it's okay. I'm not mad at it. That's pretty much it for the packaging. He also comes with, as most third party or officials come with, a set of instructions, which is pretty good. Nice little artwork there. And it's not just an instruction manual, it's also a little bit of a mini comic. Now, just to get off on a mini rant here, I was looking through this comic, and it's nice. And I noticed the design on each of the figures. And I kept saying to myself, that looks familiar. And then it hit me. It's one of these. This is also a KFC. This is their take on a Perceptor, if you couldn't already tell. Now, this guy, I am not the biggest fan of. I bought him, and don't get me wrong, the guy's got posability for days, but he's almost untransformable. There were so many parts, the wrists were just super loose. I had to kind of jimmy rig him to not be all just limp wrist. His microscope part was just, it wouldn't stay, so I kind of glued it in because it would never stay up. And it's a shame because it's a decent looking figure. And like, if you can see, he's got some nice light piping going. He came with alternate heads as well. And I did like the dual wielding. He has a gun holster. So awesome looking figure. Like I said, it's posability for days, but it has so many flaws. And I've noticed going through KFC's library, they make a whole bunch of figures in this exact same mold. And really, no, I'm sorry, KFC. This is not your best. Now, I get it. It's a very cheap. I got it on sale. It was like less than $40. So it's like I can't complain too much, but I will critique and say this is definitely not one of your best. I was going to put him on my worst disappointing list, but I forgot about him so much that I forgot him. I literally forgot him. Like, I blocked him out. That's how much of a disappointment he was, that I blocked him out, that he didn't end up on that list. Because if I remembered him, he'd have been on that list, because he was definitely something that had some promise, but had a lot of things disappointing. Like I said, posability for days. Like, you can get him in all kinds of poses, but just a lot of loose joints. His feet, very loose. He really got to be patient to keep him standing. And then to find out there's like a dozen different molds. They have a Soundwave, they have a Blaster, and other figures in the exact same mold. That once I saw that, I'm like, okay, I bought this one. I am never getting another one in this mold again. And that's unfortunate because, like I said, he had promise. But enough about that rant. I just kind of had to get that off my chest because this guy's like, when I see him sometime, he vexes me. Plus, his transformation was just weird and just didn't look like a microscope or anything. It was just really weird. It almost didn't work. Maybe that was just my figure. I don't know, but I've heard really never any good things about these figures. So, like I said, I got them on the cheap. I probably wouldn't get another mold from KFC with these guys. Not a fan. But enough about that dude. It's not about him. I'm sorry I had to get that off my chest. Really did. Because it vexes me. It does vex me. But like I said, the only reason I thought of him is after I looked at this comic and seen the design of each one of the characters in this comic. You know, they all had that same design. They all had that same design of the Perceptor. And it wasn't until the end that you actually get a proper Perceptor. And then you have your instructions, which pretty simple instructions. It's a lot of tabbing involved, which can be a good thing and might be a bad thing because it's like, you know, if a tab breaks, then you're kind of SOL. So you got to be patient with this guy. He also comes with his collector card, which has that same piece of artwork on the box, which looks good, really sturdy, has his tech specs, not bad. He also comes with Hi-Fi, which is their take on a Masterpiece Rewind. And this guy is also something that we'll need to talk about because looks good. I mean, tape mode, we'll get into that in a moment. But it comes in a nice kind of dark, cloudy holding case. He too does come with a card of his own. Tech specs, as always. And KFC. I don't know when I see KFC. I just think of chicken. It's just me. And that's pretty much it for that. Now, accessory-wise, he does come with a set of speakers. He does have his one-off, which is two sets of speakers from that episode when he was battling Soundwave, which we'll get into in robot mode, which they look really good. Nice gold finish on them. Really nice. And of course, he comes with his alternate head, which is very G1 comic book and old school toy look to it. It's not a bad head. I'm not a fan of this head because I'm used to just the cartoon. I do, you know, I've read the old comics, I collected them, but I was more of a fan of, you know, the G1 face, not really this kind of football helmet thing he's got going on here. But it does have nice details, some nice yellow eyes going on. Paint job is pretty top. So, you know, I'll give him that. And then also, Hi-Fi or Rewind, as you want to call him, he too comes with alternate heads, which this is kind of part of my complaints on this figure a little bit. He comes with, let me get a nice little head here, kind of an IDW look. And if you really want the IDW look, he's got one with the little like recorder on it. Now, my issue with this, if you can't already tell, is that the paint job is not that well done. As you can see, it's like they stopped that one coat and just let it kind of dry not so properly. So it's not the best. And that's a disappointment because I wanted to switch the heads off, but it just doesn't look right. And that paint job is just like kind of lazy, if you ask me. It's kind of lazy. And take a look at the other head again, and it's the same results. It's kind of lazy, as you can see. Even with the eyes, it's like not really all that finished. And also, they came in this little baggie here, and as you can see, paint chips. So, like I said, the paint job was not the best because there's flakes of paint in the bag that the heads came in, which is really disappointing. He also comes with a set of guns, two of them. And they look good, nice little gold finish. But here's the problem. They hardly fit in the guy's hand. Now, I don't know if that's too much paint on the gun, too much paint on the hand, but like to put them in his hand is a very tight squeeze, which we'll get into that in a moment as well. And then last but not least, he comes with this. I don't know what this is, but it came with the figure. I don't know what it does. I don't know what it's for. If anybody knows, you know what? Now that I look at it, I think I might know what this is. This looks like it might be light piping. You know what? Well, when we get to the robot mode, we'll look at this again because I'm thinking this might be light piping. It really might be light piping. We'll get back to that. I think I answered my own question, but on to the figure. Now, let's start with this guy. Like I said, I had issues with him, and we'll take him out. Looks really good, Nice cassette. I mean, paint job is a little bit sloppy, but for what it's supposed to be, I can let some of that slide. Robot side looks really good, nice black gold finish. If you wanted to compare him to a Masterpiece cassette, here he is with Buzzsaw, which pretty much same size. He is a little, say a little bit thicker, he's got a little more beef on him. There is some kind of like paint there. Like I said, it's parts of it is just really sloppy work, which is really disappointing. Like it really is. Like it's one of those things that make you think about purchasing other figures from certain companies when you see the work that you get from them, especially if you're gonna pay that kind of money. It's really one of those things that make it like, do you want this in your collection? Do you need this in your collection? You gotta kind of ask those real questions. But to transform this guy, we'll get that out the way right now. Basically, you want to take the legs, just pull it apart. You'll separate, spread the chest. Legs will accordion out. Take the foot, turn it around. Take this little hinge here, just bring it down. Same on the other side. Pull it out, bring it around. Take the foot, twist it, bring that little piece down. Take your arms, just pull them out, turn them sideways, turn the fist, same here. And then what you want to do is you want to take this part right here and just bring it up. Same on the other side. And then you'll just take your head and there you have Rewind. Which, like I said, he's not a bad looking figure. The head sculpt that he does come with is definitely old school G1, which is not bad. I mean, it's like I said, it's not a bad looking figure. He's decent. It's just unfortunate that there's just a lot of things that could be better. Now, like I said, if you wanted to swap the head, just take the head off. And if you wanted to replace it, just pop it on. And like I said, I wanted to display him this way, you know, give him that IDW look. But because of just how the paint job is, it's kind of hard to look at because it just doesn't look finished. It's like I did it or something, but I didn't, you know. So it is kind of a disappointment. So, and also, because they didn't really paint the back of the head, if you were to transform it back, you just have a white spot. So I'm just going to stick with the traditional G1 head. It's still a decent looking head. I'm just going to have to, like I said, make do. Now, as for articulation, everything's pretty much in a ball joint, so you get full 360. Arms can go out that much. It's got a double jointed elbow. No bicep swivel. Does have a wrist swivel. No waist swivel. Legs on a ball joint, so you can get out about there. Do a bit of a high kick. Legs go back that much. And you pretty much have like a double jointed knee. And as always, he does have ankle tilt forward and back. And you got a bit of a rock there. So, like I said, there's some good and there's some bad with this guy. Now, back to his weapons. When I was trying to put him in the hands, it, like, let me just see if you can see it. It doesn't really want to fit. It's a super, super tight squeeze on that. Like, almost like there's too much paint going on because it's in there. Like, I got to really put some muscle just to get that out now. And I shouldn't have to do that. Now, I'm not saying it should be totally loose, but it shouldn't be that tight. It really shouldn't be that tight. So, like, yeah, it's a tight squeeze. And I'm afraid if I were to keep doing that, eventually paint or something's going to come off. But, yeah. Now, I know what you're thinking. There's other versions of this transistor in a kind of a chromed out red. This one's more of a G1 color. That version they didn't have available anymore, but this one I like color wise more because it is more G1. And the arms, I think they used to be die cast, but I think they switched them to plastic because there were talks about paint chips. Now, this one's not chipping any paint because I think they just decided to go with the plastic, which is definitely a good idea. Seeing as how everything else is kind of a little wonky on this dude. But, you know, it's a thing. Now, just quick, I'll bring out my boy Rumble. And they look good together, similar size. But just the thing, if you could tell, a masterpiece from a third party. This one, a lot more love was put into it. A little more quality control. This one, not so much. But, like I said, they do look good together, though. So, I'll give him that. Now, I'm not going to give him a score. I'm just going to rate him with the entire package. So, we'll get to him later when it comes to the final tally. Now on to the meat and potatoes of this thing. Let's look at Blaster. And he does look great in his radio mode. Don't get me wrong. There's some good and there's some bad about this guy as well. But as far as his radio, boombox, whatever you want to call it mode, looks really good. Does look good. Can open up to put rewind in there, and he does have the similar feature that Soundwave has where you can put more than one tape in, switches on the back, and, you know, pushes the cassettes forward. So he has that feature, which is cool. Nice little handle. Give you a feel like a real live boombox. I mean, paint on it is decent. There are some parts of the paint which look a little bit unfinished, like here. And a couple of these buttons here look just... paint job is a little bit sloppy. But then there's some parts on it where the paint job looks really good. And then you can see you got your power button. You know, you have your volume. You got, you know, all your tuners. Headphone jack. So it's got, like, you know, back of it's pretty decent. Like I said, if you look here, there's a lot of detail in there. And the paint job in there looks good. It's not bad. Also has storage for his two guns, which we'll show later, which he can hold in his boombox mode, which is decent. As you can see, some nice other paint apps on there. And like I said, he's a decent figure with a few flaws. But I would say let's just get into transformation, shall we? So we can take a final look at this guy. Now, I haven't transformed him that much, but his transformation is not that difficult. So, first thing you want to do, just in case you forget, take these pieces and just flip them over. Just kind of get these out of the way. So, keep that in mind. What you'll do is, let me just bring this down a little bit. What you want to do is... take here, and pull up on this one, like that. So, pull this piece up, pull this one down. Don't go the other way or you might end up breaking that off. So, also keep that in mind. And what you'll do from here is, basically you'll untab. Let me see, it's tab here, bring that up. Bring that up. You'll want to untab from here, separating the leg and his arms. And you'll want to pretty much untab from there. And just kind of flip that up. And as you can see, there's some nice mall molded detail here, which looks really good. Then what you'll do is, kind of, you need a little clearance, so you got to lift this up a little bit and then bring this piece down. And you kind of lift that up. Take the leg, which is on a nice ratchet knee there. You take this part here and you want to flip this up. So flip that up, which will bring the foot out. And then you take out your heel spur. And then you want to take that same piece and basically, you can see, bring it back to where it was. Place that down. I think I'm doing something wrong here. Hold on. Give me a minute. I think I did something wrong here. Hold on. It's like I said, it's, it shouldn't be that hard because I was doing this right before I started recording. And don't you hate that? Like, every time, I don't know what it is about me when it comes to recording and transforming, because it's like, you just did it literally 5 minutes ago, Smith. How are you now all of a sudden forgetting what you did? Like, you just did this. How are you now forgetting? Oh, yeah. Now I got it. Push this in. Push that in. Pull that in. See, I kind of had a moment of brain fart. And then what you'll want to do is twist this around, put that flat, fold that in, and then take this piece. There's a tab right there, a slot right there, and you'll just lock that into place. You got your leg. Do that again over here. Let's try not to have another brain fart. And do the same thing. You want to get that in, which these two now will tab together, and you can lock them in by pushing these two pieces in. That'll hold that all together. Bring your foot. Let's get the foot out. Same thing here. Bring it out. Bring out your foot. Get your heel spur going. If I can get it out. Okay. Get that, fold that back in. Fold that in. Fold that in. Fold that around. And that. And same thing. Plug that in. Now you got some legs. Now, as you can see, there's parts of his gun already attached, so you're going to want to pull those off. Just got to get those out of the way. Which they're all tabbed in really tight. I normally would skip putting the weapons in, but I just kind of wanted to show that off, you know, for you guys out there, that it can be done. But normally I don't really bother with that. Then what you want to do is, I need some clearance first. Take your arms. Oh, I actually do have to get this piece out too as well. Everything is very tight, tabbed in. Lesson learned. Not going to do that again. Okay, alright. Let's bring that up some. And what you'll do here, we'll get your arm going. As you can see, these two kind of on the slot. You want to kind of just bring them forward. Take these pieces here. Let's bring it forward. Then what you can also do is take this back section, lift this piece, bring these up. And then now you can rotate at the waist. Also, turn your legs at the thigh. And there you go right there. Take these pieces here, just kind of fold them up. Nice and easy. Make sure everything's tabbed into here, because if not, the leg will kind of split. So there is a tab to just hold all that into place right there. Keeps it in tight. Big enough, okay. Then here, last but not least, on the arms, which is probably the easiest one. And it's very clever, too, how they put this together. Is what you'll do is you'll take this flip here. You want to pull this back to release the hand. But before we even do that, we'll just show you real quick. Fold that in there. Fold that in there. Bring this around. And there's a tab and a slot. And just tab that in. As far as speakers go, as you can see, just plug those in. And now you got speaker hands, which is pretty cool. But I need to get his fist, so we'll just untab that there. Flip that. Flip that. Bring this down. Pull out the fist. Close it back up. Bring it down. Bring it down. Tab that in. And there you have that. Same with the other side. Bring it up. Pull out the fist. Now you got to make sure with his fist. They are in a certain position, because if you don't, they will get stuck, and you don't want to do that. Trust me, you don't. You will be very frustrated, and you will get mad. Trust me. And you just plug that in there. Bring it around. Tap it in. And last but not least, take this piece, flip up the head, close it up, and we are done. Here we are. You got yourself a blaster. Now, he looks really good. Don't get me wrong. He looks really good. Very decent looking figure. Got a lot going for him. And seeing as how Takara doesn't seem to be making a masterpiece blaster anytime soon, I will say this. He's probably the best you're going to get at this moment. As far as G1 accurate, he's probably the best you're going to get right now. Because I haven't seen any other companies make an official blaster. He's the best is what you're going to get right now. Truly, in my honest opinion, yeah, he's the best you're going to get right now. And he does it well. Don't get me wrong. He does it really, really well. I just have a couple issues with him. One, his elbows. Like, he doesn't have, he looks like he wants to have a double jointed elbow, but he doesn't. It's just a really weird configuration. Now, while I get into that, let's get into the articulation. He can give you a full 360. And as I'm looking at that, this, I think that's light piping. I'm kind of tempted to kind of unscrew his head and really see if this is some light piping right here. You know what? Let's do. And I was right. It is light piping. Yes, it is. But as you can see, it's not really the best piping. I mean, I'm putting it up to the light and it's not that strong of a light piping. I mean, you're basically just going to have to unscrew the head right there, pull the front of the face off, and replace the piece. Simple, but it's not that strong of a light piping. I mean, I put it up to the light and I'm not seeing that much of a difference. I mean, can you really tell this light piping going on in there? And I'm trying to put them up to the light to kind of see if I can get a better look. Let me see. Can we try to bring the light up? Can we get some piping? Anything? Not much. So, as excited as that was, I thought it would be, it's not really that much of an excitement. I mean, I appreciate the touch to give him some light piping, but it doesn't really do much. I think I might just go back to the other eyes, because now he just kind of looks like he has dead eyes. I don't know. I'll think about it. But back to articulation. He can do full 360. Head can go up and go down. His ear things are adjustable. Don't ask me why. They just are. So you can go up and down with them. Arms can do a full 360. Like I said, gives you 90 degrees, bicep swivel, wrist swivel. We'll get to the hands in a minute. Does have a waist swivel. Lift up the hip skirts. Get you up that much. Go back about that much. It's got thigh swivel. 90 degrees, nice little ratchet at the knee. And it's got ankle tilts down, not much up, and a decent rocker. Now, let's get to these hands. KFC, we need to talk about your hand game. You guys have seen my Dinobot fan toys videos. I've said that at least twice already. They need to step this up. Now, the problem I have with my hands are here. They're all on little ball joints, and they are very articulated. You know, you can really get a lot of poses with these hands. The problem is just the stability. When I first got this guy and took him out of the box, I was messing with this hand. Just this hand. Why did a finger fall off on this hand? Didn't even touch this hand yet. Was touching this hand. And the finger just fell. Just fell off. Just fell off. Didn't even touch it yet. Just fell off. That shouldn't happen. This is an over $100 figure. Fingers should not be falling off. At all. And to make matters worse, I have another figure from X-Transbots, which I now come to find out that X-Transbots and KFC are pretty much under the same umbrella. And guess what? The same thing happened. Messed with one hand, finger fell off on the other. And didn't even touch the other hand yet. So, to me, that is unacceptable, man. Like, seriously. We here in this community of Transformers, we spend our money, our hard-earned money, for figures to add to our collection. The least you guys can do is make it so things don't fall off, even if you don't touch them. Like I said, I didn't touch it. The finger just fell off. Now, luckily, it's on a little ball joint, so I just popped it back in. But honestly and truthfully, I really don't mess with his hands all that much because I'm afraid they're going to fall off. I'm afraid these ball joints aren't going to be that sturdy and one day just break off and then he's going to be missing a finger, which I shouldn't have to live that way. I shouldn't be living in fear that I can't pose my figure's hands because I'm afraid they might fall off and never be able to go back on. Especially for something I paid over $100 for. So, KFC, if you're listening, X-Transbot, if you're listening, I like your figure, but step your hand game up. And I'll even throw out Apollyon. And Apollyon's one of my favorite figures. And he's also from X-Transbot. And his fingers are not the best quality either. I don't even mess with his hands. Because, yeah, his thumb, he's got a wonky thumb, and it was like that out of the box. And again, over $100 figure. It's unacceptable, man. Step your hand game up. Step it up. Take a page from, you know, Fans Toys. Take a page from Masterpiece. Take a page from Nakara. If you can't get your hand game that steady, either make it a solid piece with one finger or you better bolt all that in. But ball joints? No, man. No. No, no, no. Give him the finger. No, 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 no. Yeah, let's not do that, man. It's not a good look. Really isn't. Because that right there kept him from getting the score he got. And he was about to get a better score if the light piping worked. But seeing as how that doesn't work either, I guess I'm sticking with my original score. And that's sad to say, because like I said, outside of every other company, he is pretty much the definitive Masterpiece blaster, because I don't see anybody making a blaster. I don't see the car making a blaster. So this, if a person's a completionist and wants to have a whole G1 set and they need a blaster, you guys pretty much got a stranglehold on that right now. Because he's as close as it gets. But you can make him better. You can make him better. Just step the hand game up. You know, I got here, my bicep looks like it's about to come off. See that? It's like a nice little gap going on. Like, what's that? Come on, man. I pay good money. I want quality figures. If I wanted crap figures for cheap money, then I'll go get a knockoff. Or just stick to the Hasbro stuff. But I want quality figures that look good on my shelf. And this, stuff like that's unacceptable. Things like that are preventable. And I have another review coming, like I said, with an ex-transbot figures, and it's going to have the same issues. Same issues. Oh, no. And don't even get me started on the foot. Don't even get me started on the foot. But like I said, that in itself is a whole nother review. Like, I almost dread doing that review because that means I have to transform it again. And that foot, if anybody knows what I'm talking about, if you have this figure, then you already know what I'm talking about. It's an ex-transbot. And his foot is just obnoxious. That's all I'm going to say about that. As far as his weapon is concerned, basically take the gun, pull the latch, plug it in. And he does hold the weapons well. He does. Just take my word for it. He holds it well. But because of his fingers, I'm not even going to put it in his hand because I, like I said, I touched his hands too much already in this review. Sorry to say it, but yeah, that's just the way it's going to be. It really is because I, like I said, they scare me. But I'm going to bring in some people and then give you guys my final thoughts if you didn't already know. And here he is with his rival, Soundwave. And as you can see, they do look good together. I will give them that. Like, they look really good together. And also for a little bonus, the notches on Soundwave's shoulders that can hold Laserbeak, he does have those same notches to hold Laserbeak. I don't know why he would, but that option is out there. So you got that. And then, like I said, they look good. And that was the selling point for me. It's like, I got a Soundwave. I needed a blaster. And searching and searching for an official masterpiece-looking blaster, there was only one, and that was KFC. Although I've always heard things about them, it was like the only choice out there you really have right now. You know, I posted a picture of this guy. Someone left me a comment basically saying the same thing. So, Transistor is our official blaster. And I answered back, looks like it is. Because I don't see Takara making one anytime soon. Now, if he was a little bit better, maybe had some more die cast, the hands were a lot more stable, then I can say he can be the official. You know, we wouldn't have to worry about Takara making one because KFC already took that, you know, took care of that for us. But this thing needs to go back to the drawing board. Like, you should take it and redo it or make upgrade kits for the hands, like new hands, you know, send people, you know, some new hands, something, you know. And, I don't know, like, my rage kind of, you know, this video's kind of got me a little bit. But before I wrap it up, let me lighten the mood a little bit, you know. And here he is with his boy Jazz getting the party started. They about to crank out them hot tunes. You know, you see my man Rewind, he's already ready to get down with it. And, you know, looks really good. Like, you know, he's not perfect, but he'll do. Out of a 5, I'm like in between a 3.5 or a 4. So I'm gonna go with 3.5. There's parts of him that are sloppy. Hands are sloppy. Some of the paint jobs are a little bit sloppy. There should be ratchets where there need to be ratchets. Like, the only part of him that's ratchet is his knees. I would think he should need some in the arm department as well. He's got some gap issues on the bicep as if it looks like it's ready to fall off. Head's a little wonky, but, you know, he's not going to be doing too much movement. It's, like I said, the fingers, man, the hands really, really need to step it up, man. Like, there's too many other good third parties out there knocking it out on the hand game that you out here giving us this kind of mess for that kind of money. Really, it really is. But you had me over a barrel. I needed a blaster. And you guys are the only one that have an official masterpiece size scale blaster. But you're getting a 3.5. Now, do I recommend this figure? Like I said, unless you truly need a masterpiece size blaster, then yeah, he's your guy. There's no one else right now. He's your guy. Is he good? He's okay. Transformation's not that difficult. Like I said, there is a lot of tabbing, which then brings the risk of tabs being broke just the way it's designed. But if you just plan on having him on your shelf in robot mode, then you should be all right. He's far from perfect. He is a good-looking figure. Don't get me wrong. Like, I hate to be that kind of person that, you know, craps on him, but then says, yeah, he's good. But that's just the way it is right now. Like, he isn't perfect. Them hands are garbage. But he's a good-looking figure. And he looks good on my shelf. So, I recommend him, but I recommend him with a grain of salt. Like, be careful with the hands. You know, the paint job's not the best, but for what he does do it well. So I'll give him that much credit. Rewind, again, sloppy paint job, and that also goes with the 3.5. There's a sloppy paint job on the other faces, the hands too small to hold the weapons. It's just a whole lot of shenanigans going on with this guy. But like I said, if you truly need a blaster, he's the man for the job. So I'll recommend him with a grain of salt. A 3.5. He's okay. Can use some work. But he's not obnoxiously bad. He just has some flaws that the type of flaws that should have been improved before they even started shipping. You know, you send out these test samples to other YouTubers, and I'm pretty sure they all said the same thing, but you didn't follow through with their commentary on fix the hands. So I'll say it one more time. KFC, X-Transbots, step your hand game up. And with that being said, as always, I appreciate you guys coming to my channel. You know, just trying to help people out here, man. You know, we spend a lot of money on these figures. You expect some kind of quality. You know, I'm not the only one here dropping dollars. So, and we all want that same thing. We want a good-looking figure that's going to be on our shelves on display for the world to see or just for yourself to see. And if you're going to pay that kind of money, give me good quality. And that's from head to toe. Just because the face looks good doesn't mean you can get off on giving me those kind of hands. But anyway, as always, follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Facebook. Follow me on Google+. I'll leave a link in the description down below. If you do need yourself a transistor, you can get him from TF Source, which I will leave you a link in the description down below. As always, if you're new to my channel, welcome. And for Blaster, aka Transistor, just be your boy Smith. Keep it greasy, keep it easy, and I'm rolling out. Peace.